Okay. Good morning, one and all. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you all. On behalf of Chemical Engineering Department, SVIT, I take this opportunity to welcome you all with the Honorable Principal Dr. K.T.V. Reddy and today's speaker, Mr. Sudhir Shah, for his expert talk on energy saving for lighting, electric motor, AC, refrigeration system, correct priority while doing the energy conservation project, electrical vehicle and hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. I just introduce in brief about Mr. Sudhir Shah, Sirji. He has completed chemical engineering from Gujarat University, and he has also 5 years of pharmaceutical industrial experience, 10 years of experience in energy conservation project, 10 years of experience in HVAC industries, and he is currently working in PCRA, that is Petroleum Conservation Research Association, Government of India, as a faculty trainer. So I hope you all enjoy this session. So without spending much more time, I am requesting Mr. Sudhir Shah Sirji to proceed your session. Thank you, Sudhir sir.
Yeah.
Sudhir sir, please proceed your session.
Okay. Just share, make me host.
Yes, sir, wait a minute. 1 minute. So you are now host.
Okay.
Okay, you can proceed. Thank you, sir.
Image is clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to webinar organized by PCRA Mumbai and SVIT Nashik. Today, we have gathered here through webinar to discuss the topics as suggested by sir. Just a minute. So, a brief introduction about PCRA before going ahead. PCRA is a part of a Ministry of Petroleum, Government of India. Apart from the main work of research and development in the field of conservation of petroleum products, we also do education campaign like this in colleges. Similarly, we do same thing in industry also. In field activities, we help companies getting ISO 50001 certification. That is norms for energy saving compliance. We do energy audit of a big company and several other things we do. We also do mass awareness among the public for our need of energy conservation. We give ads on TV as well as print media. I will show you here two ads, such ads on our TV, and then our message by of our minister. Our second ad on TV. Just a minute.
sensibly. Use your clutch sparingly. Drive at speeds between 45 to 55. Switch your engine off at traffic red lights.
That saves money.
Save petrol. Save money.
Okay.
सबसे बड़े स्रोत लेकिन दोनों ही सीमित मात्रा में उपलब्ध थे। दोनों ही तेजी से समाप्ति की कगार पर, दोनों में ही व्यर्थ जाने की असीमित संभावना।
आज हम लोग जो ऊर्जा की खपत करते हैं उसमें से 40% तेल और प्राकृतिक गैस से ही पूर्ति होती है। क्या हम सारे विषय आज ही खपत कर दें या भविष्य के लिए रखें, इसको हमको आज तय करने की समय आई है।
जिसे मिनिस्टर सर कह रहे थे कि 40% ऑफ अवर एनर्जी नीड्स कम फ्रॉम द पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स, रेस्ट 30% कम फ्रॉम द कोल। सो अप्रोक्सीमेटली वी आर डिपेंडेंट अपॉन फॉसिल फ्यूल फॉर अपॉन 70-75%। सो दिस इज नॉट अ गुड सिनेरियो बिकॉज एज यू नो नेचर टेक्स सो मच लॉन्ग टाइम टू मैन्युफैक्चर क्रूड ऑयल and coal. What is crude oil? Crude oil is nothing but decomposed oil derived from sea or fish animal, and coal is nothing but decomposed tree or wood. So nature takes almost 2 crore years to manufacture crude oil, and in last 200 years of industrial revolution in the world, we have consumed more than 50% of available stock. This clearly indicates this scarcity of raw material. Biggest revolution which you are going to witness in your lifetime is change of form of energy. So apart from this concern of short supply of raw material, we have other concern also. When you burn a fossil fuel, coal or crude oil products, you generate carbon dioxide in the exhaust gas, and due to which global warming and climate change occurs. You already know this, and I won't go in much detail regarding it. So we are now covering ENCON skill, energy conservation skill is important for you. Why it is important? Because first, if you conserve energy, existing resources will last longer time, and at time we get more time to develop alternative technology. We are saving global warming, climate change when you do energy conservation. Less pollution will be there. We will be save foreign exchange because we are net importer of the oil. You will save money when you save energy. And our last point, I have written your career fast track solution. Why I have written here? Because today I am going to share with you some new technology in the energy conservation field, which you will be the first person to share with your future employer. So you may note down whenever you feel so. I am not a banker, but this is indicates how much importance of money saving. One time 100 rupees at 10% interest becomes 1 crore in 150 year. And 20 per day, that is 600 per month, becomes at 10% interest 1 crore after 50 years. See, so much value of saving is there. When you conserve energy, you save money also. So when you do install an energy conservation appliance, you did not save 600 per month, but just by installing a 5,000 rupees appliance, you can save 600 per month. Example is replacing your electric geyser with a gas geyser. It comes with 5,000 rupees and you will save 1 crore rupee in 50 years in your energy bill. So this is how it works out. This indicates how much energy efficient we are. We are spending 3.7 times more energy than Japan for same amount of work done. And we are spending 1.5 times world average. This indicates tremendous scope available in India for energy conservation work. So anyone who masters this line or do higher education in this line, you will have a tremendous amount of opportunities. as we I said, we are going, we have scarcity of raw material. So what are the alternatives? Only two alternatives have emerged so far. One is battery operated MMM, and second is hydrogen. I'm talking about transport sector. For our automobile sector, there are only two alternatives available. One is battery operated vehicle, and second is hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. So today we will compare the both. You already know the battery technology, but I will brief you first about hydrogen. This is the energy density chart of a hydrogen versus a petrol diesel. Here, gasoline or petrol is kept at arbitrary level of 1. This is chart for energy content per volume here. This is energy content per weight. So arbitrarily, petrol is kept at the level 1 for volume also, and 1 for by weight also, for sake of comparison. Now you can see liquid hydrogen is here, compressed hydrogen gas is here. This indicates they are more efficient than petrol and diesel when compared by weight, but they are inferior when compared by volume. If you remember, our space organization ISRO sent Chandrayaan to the moon some 1.5 years back. They used liquid hydrogen as a fuel in the Chandrayaan to propel the rocket. So this indicates how much density is there. And apart from more density, it has some other advantages also. Compared to petrol and diesel car, when you operate your car with hydrogen, you have three advantages. First, there is no short supply or scarcity of raw material. Hydrogen is available in seawater as H2O. We can separate it out and use it, so no concern of short supply. Second, in exhaust gas of a hydrogen vehicle, there is a pure water vapor. So there is no carbon dioxide and no harm to the climate change and no global warming. And third, it is a silent one. So it is a not noise making thing. So I will show you a few slides here. Hydrogen car is a basically electric car only, but electric car electricity is manufactured inside the car and not like a battery. So depending upon your size of tank, you can travel. If your tank is bigger, you can travel 1,000 kilometers. If tank is smaller, you can travel 500 kilometers. And when this car is idling, I mean, it is stationary, but its engine is kept on. It generates DC power, and this DC power can be used to for external work also. It can run for entire night. It can run and for a bungalow, including your air conditioner and everything, can be kept on for entire night if you do if you keep your hydrogen car on. In short, this will work as a digiset. So in future, you will have a car as a digiset, and your boiler will be also of this technology, hydrogen technology. These few parts are there. This is a Hyundai president with a hydrogen car. Our Prime Minister Modi ji with a Hyundai president in hydrogen car. I will show you here a small video. You will understand how this technology works.
हाइड्रोजन और ऑक्सीजन के बीच केमिकल रिएक्शन होती है जिसकी वजह से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और पानी बनता है। गाड़ी में हाइड्रोजन स्टोर करने के लिए हाइड्रोजन टैंक्स होती है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी स्टोर करने के लिए बैटरी होती है और फ्यूल सेल होता है, और साथ ही में गाड़ी चलाने के लिए इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर होती है। यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं, जब गाड़ी चलती है तभी हाइड्रोजन टैंक में स्टोर किया हुआ हाइड्रोजन और बाहरी हवा में मौजूद ऑक्सीजन फ्यूल सेल में कंबाइन होते हैं और इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोड्यूस होती है, और साथ में पानी बनता है जो कि एग्जॉस्ट पाइप से बाहर निकलता है। हाइड्रोजन टैंक में हाइड्रोजन भरने के लिए फ्यूल पंप होता है जो कि कुछ प्रेशर तक ही टैंक में हाइड्रोजन फिल करता है और इसके लिए अप्रोक्सीमेटली 3 मिनट का टाइम लगता है। अभी दोस्तों जब हम गाड़ी चलाना शुरू करते हैं यानी कि गाड़ी की स्पीड कम होती है और ड्राइविंग लोड बहुत कम होता है तभी सिर्फ गाड़ी की बैटरी ही गाड़ी को पावर देती है। इस टाइम पर हाइड्रोजन और ऑक्सीजन की रिएक्शन नहीं होती है और फ्यूल सेल इनएक्टिव होता है। अभी जब हम गाड़ी की स्पीड थोड़ी बढ़ाते हैं यानी कि पहले से थोड़ा ड्राइविंग लोड बढ़ता है तभी फ्यूल सेल एक्टिव हो जाता है और हाइड्रोजन और ऑक्सीजन की रिएक्शन शुरू हो जाती है और इससे बनी हुई इलेक्ट्रिसिटी से गाड़ी चलती है और उसके साथ ही जो बैटरी होती है वो भी चार्ज होती है। अभी दोस्तों जब हम गाड़ी को स्लोप से ले जाते हैं यानी कि जब हमें गाड़ी को अपहिल चढ़ाना होता है तभी गाड़ी पर ज्यादा लोड होता है यानी कि हाई लोड ड्राइविंग मोड एक्टिव होता है। दोस्तों इस टाइम पर फ्यूल सेल भी एक्टिव होता है और साथ ही में गाड़ी की बैटरी जो चार्ज हुई होती है उसका पावर भी गाड़ी चलाने में यूज होता है यानी कि इस कंडीशन में दोनों कंबाइन काम करते हैं। अभी दोस्तों इसकी अपोजिट कंडीशन देखते हैं यानी कि जब हम डाउनहिल ड्राइव करते हैं तभी एनर्जी रिकवरी होती है यानी कि इस टाइम पर कार को चलाने के लिए कोई पावर की जरूरत नहीं होती है, फ्यूल सेल इनएक्टिव होता है और साथ ही में गाड़ी की बैटरी चार्ज होती रहती है। अभी दोस्तों इस टाइप की कार का मेन पार्ट यानी कि फ्यूल सेल के बारे में जान लेते हैं। फ्यूल सेल दो इलेक्ट्रोड से बना हुआ होता है, एनोड और कैथोड। इसमें से एक इलेक्ट्रोड पर हाइड्रोजन टैंक में से हाइड्रोजन आता है और दूसरे इलेक्ट्रोड पर हवा में मौजूद ऑक्सीजन आता है। तो इस तरीके से हाइड्रोजन और ऑक्सीजन जो कि पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव है वो इकट्ठा होते हैं और दोनों के बीच केमिकल रिएक्शन होती है और ये केमिकल रिएक्शन की वजह से इलेक्ट्रॉन नेगेटिव से पॉजिटिव इलेक्ट्रॉन की तरफ घूमता है जिसकी वजह से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पैदा होती है जिसको एक बैटरी में स्टोर किया जाता है। अभी यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं जब हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन के साथ मिलता है तभी H2O बनता है यानी कि पानी बनता है जो कि एग्जॉस्ट के जरिए बाहर निकाल दिया जाता है। इसका मतलब
हमने वर्किंग देखा हाइड्रोजन कार का। आगे जाने से पहले आई विल ब्रीफ यू रिगार्डिंग वॉर गोइंग ऑन बिटवीन टू टेक्नोलॉजी। वन साइड वी हैव हाइड्रोजन टेक्नोलॉजी दैट इज बैक्ड बाय 4 नेशंस। दिस 4 नेशंस आर 10 to 15 years अहेड ऑफ ऑल अदर नेशंस इन दिस टेक्नोलॉजी। दे आर चाइना, जर्मनी, जापान एंड कोरिया। These nations have taken hydrogen as alternative and they have done tremendous research and development work and they have come up with some models and alternatives. On other side, US and their allies and including their automobile company Tesla have done tremendous work on battery technology. In US universities, you will find many new type of batteries are being developed and they are spending millions of dollars on this battery technology. So it is like a war situation, and which technology will overpower other will depend, will come to know in the future. So I'm showing you here one such a train running on hydrogen in Germany. India, we have a largest network of railway tracks in the world, and Indian Railway is considered one of the biggest railway. Just imagine most of the time you find electric powered engine is there. So just imagine how much electricity is consumed by railways in India. And 75% of energy is electricity is produced by burning the coal. So railway is burning, so much coal is burning due to railways. But if you trains run on hydrogen, you will save a lot of coal, and there is no global warming, climate change also. So just see this video.
देखने में ये सामान्य डीजल ट्रेन जैसी लगती है जो यूरोप के उन ग्रामीण इलाकों में पटरियों पर दौड़ती है जहां बिजली की ट्रेन अभी तक नहीं चल सकी है, पर यहां जर्मनी में ऐसी ट्रेन दौड़ रही है जो हाइड्रोजन फ्यूल से चलती है और ये ऐसे काम करती है। ट्रेन पर रखे एक टैंक से हाइड्रोजन एक फ्यूल सेल में जाता है, वो हवा से ऑक्सीजन लेता है और फिर केमिकल रिएक्शन के बाद ऊर्जा बनती है। सबसे पहले आई कोयले से चलने वाली ट्रेन जिससे बहुत प्रदूषण होता था, फिर डीजल ट्रेन आई और उनसे निकलने वाली गैस भी पर्यावरण को नुकसान पहुंचाती है, पर हाइड्रोजन ट्रेन में ऐसा नहीं है। ये धुएं से निकला एमिशन है, आप इसे सूंघ नहीं सकते, ना ही आप इसे टेस्ट कर सकते हैं क्योंकि ये पानी है, शुद्ध पानी। ब्रिटेन और कई जगहों पर बैटरी से चलने वाली ट्रेनों का भी ट्रायल हुआ है। पर उनके मुकाबले हाइड्रोजन ट्रेन का फायदा क्या है?
We're using hydrogen because it's...
हम हाइड्रोजन का इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं क्योंकि एक बैटरी के मुकाबले ये फायदेमंद है। बैटरी को चार्ज करने में बहुत वक्त लगता है और उससे कम ऊर्जा मिलती है, तो समान दूरी तय करने के लिए हमें बैटरी को कई बार चार्ज करते रहना पड़ेगा।
15 मिनट हाइड्रोजन भरने के बाद ट्रेन 600 से ज्यादा मील का सफर कर सकती है और हवा की मदद से और हाइड्रोजन बना के रहा जा सकता है। जर्मनी में बनने वाले इन हाइड्रोजन ट्रेनों को सीधा इस्तेमाल में लाया जा सकेगा और इस ट्रेन के निर्माताओं को लगता है प्रदूषण से राहत पाने के लिए दूसरे देशों में भी इसकी मांग काफी बढ़ेगी।
You saw the hydrogen train running in Germany, and India has a very big plans for hydrogen. In our Independence Day speech, our Prime Minister Modi ji indicated that in future India will be hub of green hydrogen. Now I will explain you what is green hydrogen later on. Right now we see the one more video on a car running on this technology.
This is the Toyota Mirai. That means the future. And Toyota would like us to believe that this car is the future because it is the world's first mass-produced hydrogen fuel cell car. So, what is it like? So what's it like in here? Well, it's actually really nice. It's comfortable, it's quiet, it's incredibly smooth. But the real point about this car is the technology. It doesn't give you what's called range anxiety. I can drive 300 kilometers on one charge of hydrogen. In fact, at the moment, it's telling me I can go another 280 kilometers before I have to stop and refuel. And that's really different from other zero emissions vehicles. On the downside, this car is very expensive. $60,000 for this base model. That's about the same as a Mercedes-Benz or a large BMW. And I don't know, maybe it's my taste, but it's not much of a looker. So that's the other thing about this car that's different. It's very quick to refill it with hydrogen. So we've come to a station. Let's see how long it takes. So that's it. I mean, that barely took a couple of minutes. Hardly enough time to finish my coffee. Let's go. According to the advertising, the only thing this car produces is water. So let's see. Tastes like water. But the fuel this car uses, hydrogen, takes a lot of energy to make, a lot more to store, and more still to transport around the country. So the critics say this car is not nearly as clean as it's claimed to be.
You saw the guy telling this car is not neat and clean as it's claimed to be. What he meant to say, although when you drive a hydrogen car, you don't harm any atmosphere because there is no carbon dioxide in the exhaust gas. But how will you manufacture hydrogen? There is a basic question. From which raw material? One of the raw material is, crude oil or methane. And how will you process energy for converting methane to hydrogen? Electricity required can be derived from coal. So if you are using crude oil and coal to manufacture hydrogen, it is of no use. Such a hydrogen is called black hydrogen. Then you have a white hydrogen in which you are using a seawater as a source of getting hydrogen. But your processing needs of electricity comes from manufactured by burning a coal. So now you have white hydrogen. And whatever PM sir was referring in independence speech that India will be hub of a green hydrogen, it means we are one is using solar technology to get hydrogen from the seawater. When you do this, you are not having zero harm to the climate. And we witnessed in the last 1 month a tremendous amount of rain in our Satara, Chipalun and other areas. There was tremendous damage. I got the reports, the water flooding up to level 3. Three floors tak pani aa jaane se, lot of factories, shops, houses were bahut damage hua hai. Ye sare outcome hai global warming climate change ka. By doing energy conservation, you can reduce it. So before going ahead, I would like to let you know more about hydrogen. Although hydrogen is the best alternative available. See, battery-operated vehicle can drive a small thing. Currently, government has planned to use the BEV vehicle for two-wheeler and three-wheeler only. They have plan to ban manufacturing of a new three-wheeler and two-wheeler in after few years, say 3 or 4 years, you will not be allowed to manufacture scooter, bike or auto rickshaw based on petrol engine. So they are committed to convert this section into fully into battery operated. And cars are 50-50. Cars can be of hydrogen or cars can be of BEV also. Buses are plying on BEV in our metro city, Mumbai, Pune, maybe Nashik also, on electric. But you cannot run truck because load is very high. In buses, load is very low. Only 30-40 people are sitting. But in truck, tons and tons of weight is there. So you cannot use a battery to run it. Our trains cannot run on a battery. Our ships cannot run on battery. Only alternative available is hydrogen. There is no other alternative. In such a scenario, hydrogen seems like it is winning, but it is not so. Because problem with hydrogen is distribution. You may manufacture hydrogen, green hydrogen can be manufactured at any site, but how will you distribute to petrol pumps? See, right now, BPCL, IOC, and HPCL have a tanks to store liquid, not a gas. Hello. For transportation, we have tankers plying on the road. They transfer liquid. On petrol pump also, we have a tank below the ground, which is storing the liquid. No way we have a storage facility for gas. So transportation and storage is a big issue for hydrogen being a gas. Only two solutions are available. One is having a pipeline, just like we have a compressed gas pipeline, CNG pipeline for our houses in metro city. Similarly, you can have a pipeline for hydrogen, which will transfer hydrogen directly to the petrol pump. But you imagine number of petrol pumps located in India, and such a big task is there to use this network. Second alternative, which is found by Israel IIT, North Israel Institute of Technology, NIIT, that is, they have devised a small portable plant which can convert ammonia to hydrogen instantly and at a 25% cost. So these plants can be installed at a blast point. And still then, ammonia can be stored in a refinery. Ammonia can be transferred as a liquid through tanker. Ammonia can be stored below the petrol pump. But before feeding to the vehicle, it will be converted to hydrogen through this small plant. There are two alternatives I have shown you, which can be since viable. So before going ahead, I would like to share with you, if you have any questions, sir, we can answer you. Any questions in this section? Hello, sir.
Yes, yes. Any question from participants? Please ask if you have any doubt, questions.
For hydrogen, the questions, or rather, I will go at the other things.
Okay, continue, sir.
Okay. So I have something I will cover regarding battery also, because battery is alternative technology. And as I said, in the US, tremendous amount of research is going on the new type of battery. So three new promising batteries are here. We are using right now lithium-based battery. For your mobile phone, you use a lithium battery. So it has a life cycle of 5,000 times. If you charge and discharge 5,000 times, its life is over. But this gold nanowire battery can be has a life of 2 lakh times. You can see 2 lakh times you can charge and discharge, then its life will be over. So it is much, much higher. And this technology can be really boost for a automobile sector. It is developed by University of California at Irvine. I will show you a small video also here.
What if a battery lasted forever? Did it power a car? Did it power your home? Did it power change? At the University of California, Irvine, we're counting on it. UCI chemistry student Mia Litai has developed a technology that could potentially help a battery hold unlimited charges. Experimenting in the lab, she made a remarkable discovery that will have a huge impact on future energy consumption. By coating the gold nanowires in a thin gel, the filaments of the capacitor retain their properties under hundreds of thousands of charges. Call it a hunch. Call it a happy accident. We call it the power of I. When you're given the opportunity to explore and follow your convictions, when dedication and inspiration cross paths, amazing things will happen.
You saw the gold nanowire battery. Now we will see other type of graphene-based battery. Graphene-based battery is a basically carbon-based product, and structure is different. It is a if you use this technology, you will have a one charge. You can travel 500 miles or approximately 800 kilometers. So this is also a good thing. I will just show you one small video, which indicates how these graphene batteries work.
कि जो साइंटिस्ट को कहीं अगर एक वरदान के रूप में मिला है, एक ऐसा मटेरियल जिसकी एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी कैपेबिलिटीज है जो अब तक पूरे ह्यूमन हिस्ट्री में किसी और मटेरियल में नहीं पाई गई। ये मटेरियल स्टील से 5 गुना हल्का है, सिल्वर से ज्यादा इसकी इलेक्ट्रिकल और हीट कंडक्टिविटी है, डायमंड से ज्यादा इसकी हीट कंडक्टिविटी है, और ये मटेरियल बाकी सब मटेरियल्स की अनलाइकली फ्लेक्सिबल है। मतलब आप इस मटेरियल को किसी भी शेप में तोड़ मरोड़ सकते हो, बट ये टूटेगा नहीं। अब इस मटेरियल को यूज किया गया बैटरी टेक्नोलॉजी में, बिकॉज इसकी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी है, दैट इज इट बिहेव्स एज अ सुपर कैपेसिटर। ये सुपर कैपेसिटर्स क्या होते हैं? ये वो कैपेसिटर्स होते हैं जो अपने अंदर बहुत ही जल्दी जब वोल्टेज अप्लाई की जाती है, बहुत ही जल्दी एक पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज को स्टोर कर लेते हैं। अब जब भी आप अपनी बैटरी को चार्ज करते होंगे, तब क्या होता है कि पूरा का पूरा इलेक्ट्रिक करंट आपकी बैटरी को चार्ज करता है, मतलब आपकी बैटरी चार्ज को स्टोर करती है। अब जो ग्राफीन बैटरीज है, वो सुपर कंडक्टर होने की वजह से वो जो चार्ज स्टोर करती है अपने अंदर, वो बहुत ही फास्ट करती है, मतलब आपकी नॉर्मल बैटरी बहुत ज्यादा गुना तेज स्टोर करती है, जिसकी वजह से वो एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी कैपेबिलिटी दे पाती है जो हमारी नॉर्मल बैटरीज नहीं दे पाती। प्लस ये
आपने देखा अबाउट ग्राफीन बैटरी, एंड लास्ट थिंग इन हियर इज एयर ब्रीथिंग बैटरी। दिस बैटरी इज डेवलप्ड बाय टॉप इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज इन द वर्ल्ड, एमआईटी। एमआईटी यू नो, मैसाचुसेट्स इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी। सो दे हैव डेवलप्ड दिस बैटरी, एंड व्हाट इज स्पेशल अबाउट दिस बैटरी इज दैट अपार्ट फ्रॉम ऑटोमोबाइल एप्लीकेशन, दिस एयर ब्रीथिंग बैटरी कैन बी यूज्ड इन सोलर एंड wind farm. What happens with solar and wind farm, sometimes they have excess capacity or generation available, but they are not able to store. They have a storage capacity for a few days only. So this creates hindrance for them, but this technology, air breathing battery, solar and wind power will able to store their charges for few months. It means in summer, whatever peak solar rays are there, solar panel energy will be stored in the batteries, air bathing battery, and it will be released in monsoon when there is no sun. So this is a very good innovation. I will just show you a small video for this also.
Developed an air breathing battery that could store electricity for very long durations for about 1/5 the cost of just with constraints and zero emissions. It could be used to make sporadic more reliable source of electricity for the day. For its anode, the rechargeable flow battery uses cheap abundant sulfur dissolved water and solution. The cathode continuously takes in and releases oxygen that balances charge as ions between the electrodes. Oxygen flowing into the cathode causes the anode to discharge electrons to an external circuit. Oxygen flowing out sends electrons back to the anode, recharging the battery. This battery literally inhales and exhales air, but it doesn't exhale carbon dioxide like humans. It exhales oxygen. The battery's total about 1/30 the cost of competing batteries, such as lithium-ion batteries. Scaled-up systems could be used to store electricity from wind or solar power for multiple days to entire seasons for about $20 to $30 per kilowatt hour.
You saw the various type of batteries. I will show you a website of Government of Maharashtra. Maharashtra government has this website, a central website available for all sort of alternative energy. If you MEDA has a several type of other energy source of energy they are covered here. Apart from this, they also have a data for a rebate or a subsidy on these schemes. And improving energy efficiency should be looked upon as a it should be looked upon as a fossil fuel reserve. Why this? Because as I have said earlier, we have 50% scope of reduction. So rather than focusing on installing a new plant of electricity, if we do even 25%, we save half of it, then also we don't need many new plants. So there's so much possibilities here to save the energy. Sir, how much time can I go up to 12:30 is okay?
Okay, sir, no problem. Up to 12:30,
okay, na? Okay. Now we'll compare some energy conservation industry I'll cover, and then we will see priorities. First and foremost, when you do energy conservation, you have to look at power quality. Power quality first is voltage fluctuation. I have observed in the industrial units in Goregaon in Mumbai, power supply was 240, 250 for single phase or for three phase, 440 continuously up to 6 p.m. But as and when nearby big industrial units close down their operation or the load is reduced, I have seen myself power voltage shoot up to 325, 320. So this may damage your appliances. So one is voltage fluctuation and second is overall quality of power. So, who spoils the power quality? 30% is spoiled by your supplier. External factor like this.
Excuse me, sir.
Pardon?
Excuse me. Feedback link will be shared. At what time?
You can share right now also.
Yes, we can share the feedback link after 15 minutes.
Okay.
In a chat box. Participant, please note of it. Feedback link will be shared up to 15 minutes in chat box. Then you can give the feedback. and then certificate will be generated after getting the feedback. Okay, continue, sir.
Yeah, okay. If 30% of power problems are due to supply company, utility supply company problem is there. So it is 30%, but 70% of the problem, deterioration of power quality is because of internal things. Using a low power factor gadgets, transformer overloading, all these are written here. Such as you should first check your power quality before doing any conservation work of electricity. Something about electric bill also, because we have option of HT tariff. Very few people know this. It is a wholesale plan. If you have a big industry or even a university, college, big complex area, they can give HT tariff, where they will be given 11,000 volts and they have to convert to 240 or 440 as per their need. They have to commit minimum monthly charge, say 1 lakh rupees or 2 lakh rupees per month, but they easily can afford it. Anyway, their bills are more than 10 lakh rupees. So they get a tremendous amount of discount being a wholesale plan. And even a 3-4 small medium-sized industry or 3-4 small societies, big societies, can apply for this wholesale HT tariff plan. I'll cover here motor first, because motor is a such a thing, it applicable to anywhere. Even if in all type of industry, maybe electrical or mechanical or chemical, you will find the motors running everywhere, and motors contribute very large amount of power consumption. So there are 5 points you should remember for energy saving here. Motors should not be oversized, not even by 15-20%, because what happens right from design stage, design engineer, then to purchase customer, all are going for higher and higher. Suppose there is a requirement of 10.5 kW motor, but customer will buy 12 kW. Little higher is safer, but little higher doesn't make a very bad sense here, because in motor, 95% cost is running cost. And running cost would be very high if you have a oversized motor. Rewind motor after 5,000 hours of use. Rewind motor should not be used in continuous load. Speed reduction by VFD and not voltage reduction. Load survey analysis is a great energy conservation measure. What happens here is, one plant has a very different type of motors. Some are 35% load, so they are very highly over capacity. 65% here is over capacity. 35 to 50, 50, 75, 75 to 100, and more than 100. So the last two categories are okay, but first three categories, either you should swap or you should buy a new. You can save a lot of money by doing this thing. Now we'll go some details also here. This is an example of an energy cost comparison of two motors. One motor is of 0.86 efficiency, and other is of 0.88 efficiency. Both the motors are of 7.5 HP. Running cost is for 10 years is 26,16,000. Here 25,56,000. You can see difference of this much. First cost is only 2,000 more. So by paying 2,000 more, you are saving so much money in running cost. So this is how it indicates running cost is so important. Apart from this thing, I will share with you some other things also. See here, they are size of width of rotor and amount of copper used. It indicates its efficiency. Different type of losses are mentioned here. Core losses, friction losses. So you can always focus on this thing. is you should know table showing how high voltage affects motor. The 400 voltage is applied, then you get a power factor of 0.8. That is okay. But if it is 425, 435, you can see how much deterioration is there. 445, and your power factor is 0.57 only. So this is very bad. So you should must keep a check on the amount of voltage being applied to the motor. Three type of motor, as I said earlier, higher the rotor length and the more copper, it is high efficient. This reverse is the case here. Something regarding a lighting also I will cover here. See here, LED and CFL are compared. LED always scores high. If you fill, just see it scores high only when lumens are low. When lumens are up to 450, here is 4 and 5 voltage are there, and CFL is 812. So you feel LED is scoring very high. But if it is output is 2600, 2800, that is 28 here and 30 here. So it is indicates you should not buy LED lamp of higher capacity. At higher output of CFL is better. Something regarding CRI I will cover here. CRI is this color rendering index. Same image looks different with a CRI of 70 and CRI of 91. Sun has a CRI of 100. So this indicates a difference in color. Three type of lamps are here: mercury vapor, metal halide, and high pressure sodium. This is used in outdoor. As you can see here, CRI is only 50. See, yellow color light is there. You can't differentiate exact color, but it is life is better and the cost is down. So it is used in outdoor. Metal halide is used in both the cases because it's a good CRI is there. High pressure sodium again is a very poor CRI, but it is also used in outdoor because of low cost. I will cover our first year priority sector. What is a see here energy pyramid is there. With this energy pyramid, you can you know the priority. What is the priority of from where you will start the work? See, scope of work is everywhere. Everywhere there is scope of saving in lighting, in refrigeration, in motors, everywhere. But where you will start? First step is to stop wastage of energy. And unless this step is covered, you should not go to second stage. So this is a first step. You sun exposed wall or roof in AC room is waste of energy. Air and steam leakage is waste of energy. Keeping light and fan on for an empty room is wastage of energy. After all this work is done, it may take whatever time. You should not jump to second stage. Second stage is increasing energy efficiency by latest gadgets. All these things I will cover. BLDC ceiling fan later. Inverter AC also I will cover here. After doing this second thing, you should go to third thing. Third is a energy renewable. So solar panel, all things are last one. But what people do, people do first solar in the terrace. I have seen more than 10 engineering colleges wherein complexes they have put up solar panels. But their classroom, they have a normal ceiling fan and not a BLDC one. They have a normal flickering star tube light and not the LED or CFL. and the director's room are sun exposed room are not insulated. So if you do like this, you will not get return of money. So we'll cover here some new technology first, and as we are short of some time, these are the 8 technologies I will going to cover with you, which are new and your future employer may not be knowing it. So first thing is daylight transport technology. आप अगर कोई बैंक में जाते हो तो आपको ट्यूबलाइट और डे लाइटिंग के लिए लाइट्स चालू रहेगी, ट्यूबलाइट है या एलईडी है कुछ भी है, मगर लाइट्स आर केप्ट ऑन इन बैंक्स, ऑफिसेस, फैक्ट्रीज, शॉपिंग मॉल्स, शॉप्स, एवरीवेयर. जस्ट इमेजिन पूरा इंडिया में जितने भी कॉमर्शियल एस्टेब्लिशमेंट है वो सारे दिन के टाइम में लाइट्स ऑन रखते हैं. अभी लाइट्स इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज कंज्यूम एंड इट इज एज आई सेड अर्लियर कोल इज बर्न for up to 35% depending upon coal burning. So we are burning a coal for our daylight, but light is already available outside. Why can't we transfer this light to inside? जैसे पानी का एक पाइप है और टैप आप ओपन करते हो तो पानी बाहर से अंदर आ जाता है, क्या ऐसी कोई टेक्नोलॉजी है जहां से बाहर की लाइट अंदर आ जाए? I mean, if there is a, can you have a readable light inside? Suppose imagine a dark room. इसमें कोई विंडो नहीं है और डोर पूरा बंद है, पूरा डार्कनेस है, तो क्या आप अपना न्यूज़पेपर या बुक्स पढ़ सकते हैं थ्रू सम टेक्नोलॉजी? दिस थॉट केम टू माइंड ऑफ इन्वेंटर लॉन व्हाइटहेड. लॉन व्हाइटहेड वाज अ कैनेडियन मैन साइंटिस्ट, यू कैन से ही वाज अ बीएससी फिजिक्स एजुकेटेड. ही थॉट ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग आउटसाइड लाइट इनसाइड टू लोअर द एनर्जी बिल्स. So first he tried this multiple mirror in his hometown in Canada. He got the light inside, but there was no fun in getting a free light because along with the light rays, what came inside were UV and IR, ultraviolet and infrared. These are both the components of the sun rays. So much heating was there in the room, there was no fun in free electricity. So he discarded the idea of a mirror. But since he was a BSc physics educated man, he could invent a prism. You know the prism, we know the prism for a rainbow. Similarly, this is a prism which discards UV and IR. UV falling here will go back to atmosphere. IR falling here will go back to atmosphere. So UV and IR are moved out and only non-heat contributing light rays are allowed inside. So this is free of cost, these lights you are getting inside. Now how to distribute? There are two ways. One is just as you are seeing a pipe here, is a mirror coated inside pipe. And second is a use of optical fiber. Actually both are used. Initially pipes are used for bringing a main entry point. But when there are small and small loads are there, optical fiber is used. So I'm showing you a few slides here. This technology has a many name. It is called sun pipe. It is also called skylight. Is also called light pipe. There are 4 names: daylight transfer, sun pipe, light pipe, and skylight. So you can search with these words in Google to know more. Here is a such a lens is there. This is called Fresnel lens. This is a prism called Fresnel lens. Many such are in terrace. Lights inside is this one, is no CFL, no LED inside, and no electric wiring is done here. Only optical fiber are connected here, and you will get a light like this. If outside is sunny light, you will get a sunny light. If it is a cloudy, you will get a cloudy. You can mount the lenses on a wall also, and inside you will like this also. So this is how it works, and this technology is now available in India. Big corporate have started using it, but people don't know it. Maybe where you'll be working, they will not be knowing about it. So this is an imaginary photo of an airport. This airport is in Canada, James Richardson International Airport, in memory and recognition of inventor Lon Whitehead. Government of Canada illuminated entire airport that is located in Manitoba state in Canada with this technology. I'm showing you very small video of half a minute. You see the lights are there. They call it Skylight.
Communication specialist with Winnipeg Airport Authority. Winnipeg has a new airport, and we want to ensure you're comfortable arriving and finding your bags following your flight. If you're arriving on a domestic flight, follow the signs down to arrivals on the main level of the terminal. This area features three large baggage carousels and beautiful skylights, which allow lots of natural light to shine in.
You just saw the lights here. Yes, they call it Skylight. Here is the two area compared. One is with a light pipe, one without light pipe. So you can know the free lights, how much different it makes. Cost is around 20,000 rupees for 1,000 square feet. But this cost is coming down, and this is not much, only one time investment, and you will get a lifetime 50%, at least 50% reduction in daytime lighting cost. This is the first technology you can share with your future employer. As I said, energy saving is a very good thing. Second is a BLDC fan. Here we saw a big revolution in a lighting sector. Some 20 years ago, there was a filament bulb, which was consuming 87% of energy in heating only. And you were getting output in the form of light of 13%. Compared to this current LED technology, in the driver and a circuit uses 2%, and 98% you get back in form of light. So what a transformation from 87% wastage to 2% wastage. Such a big revolution came in ceiling fan also some 4 years back, but nobody noticed it, and still people don't know it and don't use it. This is called inertia, nothing else. Here I will compare both the fans, and I am covering here such a thing you can implement. See, if I talk for complex things, like distillation and all the cracking and all that, you will not able to use it in your day-to-day life. So this is a BLDC ceiling fan, brushless DC ceiling fan it is called. This is a normal ceiling fan with 80 watts consumption at speed of 5, but BLDC will consume only 32 watt. At speed of 1, this will consume only 3 watt. So you can understand how much saving is there, only 3 watts for ceiling fan. And in a small flat, you may have 2 or 3 bedroom. And each bedroom you have running 10 hours a night ceiling fan. So consumption of electricity is not less. So you can save a lot of money by changing, because the BLDC cost you 2,500 rupees. And you can sell your existing fan and buy a new fan. Within 1 year or so, you will your cost will be recovered. Something about AC also, because AC are energy guzzlers. Entire world power consumption of entire world, 50% comes from refrigeration and air conditioning. Just imagine, 50% of power consumed in entire world is only this section. So this is a very huge application of energy saving chances are there. So one thing is I'll cover here is inverter AC. Here you are seeing two cars for comparison sake. The power consumption chart of a gray car and a green car. Gray car represents normal air conditioner, and green car represents inverter air conditioner. Normal air conditioner power consumption rises when you do start your machine, and here thermostat takes cutoff, power consumption goes down. Thermostat takes restart, power consumption goes up. So this is chance of a power consumption chart. Compared to this, inverter AC has a linear one here, consumption. How is this happening? Does it indicate it doesn't have any thermostat? Yes, you understood right. In inverter AC, there is a VFD device and a temperature sensor fitted inside the AC. They sense the temperature, and frequency supplied to the compressor is reduced as room is getting chiller and chiller. Suppose you buy a 2-ton inverter AC and start cooling. As the room gets cooled down, frequency supplied to the compressor is reduced from 2. So your compressor becomes from 2-ton to 1.5-ton, then 1-ton, and then 0.75-ton. When your compressor is of 0.75-ton, it will not give you a big power bill. And what is the greatest benefit? greatest benefit is its usage. See, 4-star and 5-star ACs available in market are useful and only when your consumption is 7 to 8 hours a day. But for inverter AC, even if your usage is 1 hour a day and 23 hours you are keeping it off, then also you save so much money. So you can always give this suggestion to your future employer to use daylight transfer technology, to change your fans by BLDC fan, use inverter AC. Now I will cover here some solar AC. This solar AC, we have two technologies. This type of solar AC are obsolete now, so don't go for them. This was an old thing, using a 12 volt DC solar panel. So now the new technology, we are not using solar panel, but you are using a solar thermal panel. What solar thermal panel do? They store heat of sun. And this stored heat can work as a compressor load. They will, well, size of compressor will be reduced. Suppose you have required 2-ton compressor, but with solar powered air conditioner, you need to buy 1.25-ton compressor only. So your running cost will be drastically reduced. I will show you a small video here.
A patented solar thermal smart panel. It is this unique and innovative technology that combines ingenuity with practicality. The design is simple yet effective. By integrating SunTrack solar thermal smart panel with a new high efficiency air conditioner or commercial HVAC system, you can lower the amount of energy the system is using by up to 40%. That's right.
You see 40% saving. 40% is not a less, very high saving is there. So you can use this technology, and I'm sharing with you one of the company dealing in this. I'm not promoting this brand, but as the only brand available as per my knowledge in India. See, SunTrack of USA does this thing, and only dealer available in India is this thing. I'm not saying they are good people to deal with or their products are good, but just to get more knowledge, you can contact them or you can see their website. PerfectSunTech.com, that is New Mumbai. You can see the website and know more about this technology. And you can even know commercial rates and all that through this website. Something about geothermal heat pump. Now, if you dig below the earth, if you dig 10 feet below the earth's surface, you will find temperature of 10 degrees centigrade in cold climate country like Canada, Europe, and other. And you will find 16 degrees centigrade in hot country. But outside here, it is minus 0, minus 10, minus 20 here. So gradient is very high. Minus 20 is outside and plus 10 is inside. So this difference you can use for a free heat. Likewise, here outside is plus 30, plus 40. So you can use this difference for getting a free energy. What happens in cold countries like Canada and Europe, they can dig 10 foot below and a water line is kept here before feeding to a water heater. It is get warm free of cost. Similarly, in a hot country, before feeding to air conditioner, your gas is again cooled here. So this is again free of cost energy one can derive. Something about Internet of Things. Internet of Things or IoT for chiller system. Chiller system, as you know, is a central AC plant. In central AC plant, there are two types of, one is chilled water, other is refrigerant base. Chilled water system is used in big shopping mall or hotels having more than 50 rooms. In this system, chilled water is passing through inside unit. It's unlike your window or a split AC where gas is passing. So here, 7 degree centigrade is a normal temperature of water is kept, and fan behind it transfers this chilliness to the room. But what happens? There are so many variables. Load is varying. Suppose in a shopping mall, in morning time, hardly 10% occupancy is there. by evening it is 100%. Outside temperature in morning is low and afternoon is very high. So depending upon, you cannot fix arbitrarily 7 degree centigrade. So that is managed manually. But manually is not efficient, because he doesn't have all the data available, which is good for him. So this work is done by IoT. By doing IoT, you can save a lot of money. Say IoT chart is here. Saving is so much. With non-IoT, you will spending so much. With IoT, you're spending little less. So here I will show you one company dealing in this thing so that you can know more. This name of company is 75F, and you can see the entire video on their website. I will just run it for a half a minute.
Hi, this is 75F. What is 75F? Well, it's not just the perfect temperature for your building. And it's not just a team of groundbreaking, award-winning, comfort-driven engineers in Minnesota waiting for your call. It's a dynamic airflow balancing system for your HVAC. If grandma and grandpa can change their home temp...
You can see 75F and entire video, and you can learn more about IoT. So we are now, I will cover here something in alternate fuel vehicle here. I have already covered a hydrogen car, something about electric. Electric car has a major problem of recharging, first problem. Second problem is a amount of distance you can travel with single charge. See, currently, two-wheeler have a 50 to 150 capacity. So this is very less, but okay for the city ride. Your first concern, I don't have a charging time or I don't have a facility to charge, is taken care of by government initiative. Government wants to keep ready-made charge battery available at the petrol pump and also in many shops. You just go there and swap your battery. You did not charge your battery. So this is how it will work. And you will see many many shops are doing in future swapping business. So they will keep stock of charge battery. Here is a battery cost. Battery cost is going down like this in India. So it is going to down and down. So BV is a good feature for two-wheeler and three-wheeler. For cars, this indicates how much a car can travel with different type of batteries. We have our lithium-ion battery, it's about 60 kilometers. But these batteries are all ready now. Lithium sulfur, zinc air, future lithium-ion, all are ready. And that's why you are seeing ad of Tata's and other companies telling you 400 kilometer or 500 kilometer with single charge. So these are the thing in BV. BV again, it is not neat and clean. See, in hydrogen, we had a problem of manufacturing and all distribution. Here we have problem of pollution also, because you are digging out lithium or other source mineral from the earth. Instead of crude oil, you are digging out mineral, again using earth raw material. And when you discard, it is a big pollution. So critics say here also that this technology is not neat and clean. Probably hydrogen is better if we achieve distribution point of view.
Excuse me, sir.
Pardon?
Participants, their participants, feedback link shared on chat box. Please give the feedback. We continue the session. Continue, sir.
Yeah. I will show you a hybrid bike here. Hybrid bike, as you can understand, it runs on both petrol as well as electricity. So what happened, I had been to a college in Pune. Students were from automobile engineering section. And one student converted his petrol bike into hybrid bike. What results we got, every with a battery, he could run 30 kilometers in his test. 30 kilometers charge he could run on battery. Then he used to stop and then he used to change the keys and start on petrol. When petrol, he traveled 45 kilometers, his battery was again fully charged. So you can say 30 kilometer free ride with only 45 kilometer petrol ride. So this was the saving scenario. You can imagine tremendous saving is there. I'm showing you a small video here of a half a minute. Actually, this video is of half an hour. It's available on internet. You can see on internet. I'm showing you for half a minute.
और यहाँ पे हाइब्रिड बनाने के लिए तो यहाँ पे जो है इंजन का उसी जगह पे है यहाँ पे पीछे जो हमारा व्हील था उसको हमने निकाल के यहाँ पे हब मोटर डाल दिया और यहाँ से जो हमारा चैन था वो जो हमने इंजन के साथ कनेक्ट कर दिया जो हमारा इंजन से भी चलेगा और बैटरी से भी चलेगा और यहाँ पे जिसका वायरिंग जितना भी सारा जो मैंने इसके अंदर कर दिया उसके बाद जो हमारा एक्सीलेटर जो है वो यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे मैंने हैंडल पे रख दिया है तो ये नॉर्मल हमारा इंजन का एक्सीलेटर जो हमारा इंजन जो है इससे वर्क करेगा और ये जो हमारा बैटरी है उसका जो एक्सीलेटर ये है मीन्स आप ये हमारा वोल्टेज बताना चालू कर देगा। तो ये हमारा वो इंडियन से एक्सीलेटर चलने वाला है और ये हमारा जो है बैटरी से। और ये चीज अगर आप यहाँ पे निकाल के अगर इसको यहाँ पे अगर ये डाल देते हैं तो ये जो हमारा इंजन से ऑन हो जाएगा। तो मीन्स ये हाइब्रिड है, इसको आप पेट्रोल से भी चला सकते हैं और इलेक्ट्रिक से भी। चलिए देखिए इसको कैसे बनाना है। तो
You can see the video on internet, and apart from own DIY, there is a companies are also working in this line. Some companies are converting your regular bike into hybrid bike. I will share with you here such a name of one company. Again, this video is of 25 or 30 minutes. I will show you only for 1 minute. You can note down the website address and you can see the entire video on their website. GoGoEvent.com, as you have shown the website, you can see the GoGoEvent.com and see the entire video there. I will cover here something in transport sector, that is the saving of petrol and diesel in your day-to-day life. You all are traveling in two-wheeler and four-wheeler. What you can do to reduce your consumption? First and foremost thing important for you is air filter. Air filter is a single component responsible for both life of your engine and also your efficiency. So if there is a small hole in the air filter and your mechanic didn't notice that, so dust is going inside. Now this dust will cylinder bores will be wear out 45 times faster because of this dust. So this is your life of engine is suffered. Again, this clogged air filter will hamper your efficiency. What is the solution? Solution is simple. You should keep extra spare air filter available with you in your car and two-wheeler for change frequently. Don't wait till it is serviced. See, we are living in a dusty atmosphere, and because of dust sticking to air filter, air to fuel ratio is altered. Less air is entering, and so fuel is not burned properly, and you are getting poor mileage. By keeping extra air filter and changing it yourself every 3 months or every 2 months, if your ride is very high, then you will save a lot of money here. This is the first thing you should do. Tire pressure, 25 degrees in tire pressure, will have a 5 to 10% more petrol you are wasting. Again, 25% of life is also gone here. For engine oil, 2% saving with the right oil. 50 kg dead weight in your car decay. Maybe a stiffy tire or anything else you don't bother to see, you are wasting 2% of fuel oil. So these are the short, I have observed you, which are the fuel saving mechanism. Here is a bike servicing chart. Here you should remember, you should not depend upon mechanic. Note down the kilometer reading of your bike. Every 1,000 kilometer, you should change gear engine oil. 1,500, you should change air filter, spark plug. 2,000 kilometers, you should need to clutch adjustment in your carburetor. And 6,000 kilometers, you should clean your fuel tank. It will give you better mileage and life also. So this is, I have showed something in regarding petrol and diesel. A word about nitrogen tire also. See, nitrogen in the tire is a very good thing, particularly for transport sector, commercial trucks and buses and tempos. What happens? There is no expansion during summer. Nitrogen doesn't expand in the same way air expands. So you can feel little higher pressure without worrying of explosion. Higher pressure means you will get better mileage. Due to moisture in air, there is a corrosion of tire. And 30 crore tires are disposed annually. By use of nitrogen, your tire life will be increased by 30%. So you will save extra money here. And in event of a fire, nitrogen leaked out from the tire will act as a fire extinguisher. It won't supply oxygen, as is the case with the gas. Cost is around 100 to 150 rupees for four tires. Availability is a concern. Not everywhere is available. So what is the summary? If you are running a 50 kilometers daily in your car, you must use in summer. Because in summer, you have to keep air pressure less. You must have noticed people are stopping at highway, say Pune-Mumbai highway, they are stopping at starting point and reducing their air pressure. Just to be safe, in summertime, tire should not explode. So you did not do this and you can go with your regular pressure if it is nitrogen. So good carriers you have to use throughout the year. This I have covered here, our technical section is here. And before going to your some non-technical things, I would like to sure you have all have filled up the form. Sir, all have filled up the form?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Feedback form already filled up participants.
So I will go here, cover here something regarding energy certification exam. See, you are right now you are studying to get the job, and suppose you get a job in a small company, and you want change in a work in a big company, say limited company. What can help you? Being an energy auditor or energy manager, you can get this switch. So how to become an energy auditor and manager? I will explain you. Energy manager, for being an energy manager, you have to have a 3 year of experience after your BE, BTech. Then only you can allow to sit in the exam. For ME, MTech, 2 year, and for diploma, it is 6 year. I will show you. For energy auditor, what is the difference between energy manager and energy auditor? Energy auditor is a little higher degree and only engineers can achieve it. Energy manager can be any science graduate. BSc physics, BSc chemistry can also become energy manager. So this is a higher degree. And any big company will like to hire you for their production job if you have a degree of energy auditor, because the consumption of energy is very high. So this can help you to switch your career from small company to big company. Now, where to this exam? There are three websites in this line, but the last one is important, beindia.government.in. This website, we have a past question paper, guidebook, PPT, everything you need to learn, and also exam dates and everything. So you just After 3 years, he remembered to give this exam and become energy auditor. Now, something regarding on-the-job training. See, right now you are learning small things of every chapter. So, idea is to get a brief introduction of everything. But after you get a job in this particular field, you want mastery in that topic. Where you will go and who will teach you. Such a thing, scenario is faced by everyone in the industry, and the consultants, big chemical engineering consultants, formed a college in Mumbai where they are teaching these specialty things, and their students are already employed and doing a job. So I'm sharing with you name of the institute. I'm not promoting them, but I think you will be helpful to you. There are several courses that are available for chemical engineers. These are the courses. Piping engineering, process engineering, water and waste treatment, structural engineering, HSC, health safety environment. HSC means health safety environment, offshore engineering. Suppose you get a job in processing industry and you want mastery here, so you can do this course. If you are a design in piping design, you can do this course. So you can do either part-time or full-time or online. After having a job, you need to master in this area. So I will share name of institute here. Name of institute is SIT, Suvidya Institute of Technology. So it is located in Santa Cruz, Mumbai, and it is approved by all the organizations, and in fact is founded by consultants. So you can do some course here. There will be placement happening from this field also. I covered here something on education also. And one more thing from a chemical engineer, government is planning a big SEZ. See, normally chemical in the industry is very costly because you need to install boiler, air compressor, chill water system, everything you want. So you need to install so many things which cost you lakhs of rupees and a much larger area also. Government has recognized the problem of chemical industry and come up with the SEZ at Pune. So this coming up SEZ at Pune for a chemical industry will have a 7 more ready-made utility available in a metered form. So you will, just like electricity, you get in metered form. Now in metered form, you will get steam, compressor, chilled water system, pipe CNG gas, cooling water, ammonia, hydrogen, everything. So the 7 utilities will come in a metered form in SEZ coming near Pune. So new units will not have to invest in boiler, air compressor, and all this cooling tower, etc. So it will be much economical for them and much less headache for them. For no maintenance required. So these I have covered here, some things other than your technical things, and I will end this session by showing you one very small video of ISO 50001 certification on energy saving compliance.
How we face up to the world's energy challenges will heavily influence the future we leave for our children. Developing and deploying technologies for new and renewable energy sources can take time, but organizations can achieve immediate benefits by improving the way they manage energy. Improved energy efficiency can cut costs, conserve resources, and contribute to reducing global warming. The new ISO 50001 standard for energy management systems can help safeguard our future by making a positive difference in the here and now. When it comes to energy management, confidence has a nickname that's recognized worldwide. Now you know it too. It's ISO.
So, with this, I end up the session here and we'll go back to a question answer session. If any needs your... Sir, any questions?
Audience. Sir, meanwhile, you please change the host. Make the host me.
Pardon?
Please make the host. We change the host from your side. You are now host.
Okay, just a minute.
Participant, please ask the question if you have. Sir, please go in at your name and then click on more option.
Yeah, I've done it for you.
Okay. Any questions, audience? No question?
No.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
So, all participants and my dear colleagues, it's my immense pleasure to welcome you all. And vote of thanks on this expert talk on energy saving for lighting, electric motor, AC and refrigeration system. Correct priority while doing the energy conservation project, energy vehicle, hydrogen fuel cells. I, on behalf of management, principal and Department of Chemical Engineering, I would like to thank Mr. Sudhir Shah for sharing his valuable knowledge with us. And with this, we conclude this session. Thank you, Sudhir Shah.
Thank you. Just ensure all fluids have filled up the form. Huh? Yeah. Thank you and goodbye.
Okay. Thank you.
Goodbye.